Well, hello and welcome to this very special edition of Movie Burner News. It is, of course, the 91st Academy Awards edition. John, we're going to break down and talk about all the films that were categorised, the winners, the losers, or runners-up.
And I'll say losers.
We're going to start, John.
Let's not.
Because Spike Lee certainly did candy coat
anything. Spike Lee did not, no. He was throwing a right tantrum, Stephen, trying to get out of the arena.
Yeah, so we'll start with the best picture, John. We'll get right in there. Yes. As we know, the winner was Green Book. Both of us thoroughly enjoyed this film, John.
Really did,
I talked about this on the box office chat the other day. The other ones in the category who didn't win were Black KKKlansman, Black Panther, Bohemian Rhapsody, The Favourite, Roma, A Star Is Born and Vice.
Yeah, it was a very, very strong category, Stephen, I have to say. If any one of those films had won, I wouldn't really have had any gripes at all.
No.
But I did predict just about every single nomination. I think it was every nomination bar one, just a long-winded one I hadn't seen, Stephen, any of the films in. And I predicted, I thought that Roma would win. I says, who will win, Roma? But I wanted Green Book to win, and I thought the potential dark horse would have been Bohemian Rhapsody. But having looking at it, Stephen, I think every single film in that category, out with perhaps maybe a Vice, I'd say, was a potential dark horse. I don't think Vice was ever going to win in this. I thought just about everybody would have had Roma as their potential winner here. Well, it was quite a big upset for Green Book to pick it up. And as you are aware, quite a bit of controversy has been spawned out with it, picking up the best
My joint two were Green Book and Black KKKlansman, John. Mm-hmm. I'm totally in agreement with yourself. Vice, it was a good film, but I don't think it was up there with these ones. Roma, again, had a suspicion that it would be in amongst one of the favourites. The favourite, I've not seen the film, but I know from based on
It was a pretty decent film, Stephen,
Bohemian Rhapsody, I didn't think would win. I loved the movie, but I didn't think it would win. Black Panther, I don't think we're quite there with the comic book films yet to be Best Picture, unfortunately. But
Klansman's kind of a, I think that was released in maybe a slightly unfortunate period. It was a little bit set further back, but much like A Star Is Born. Yeah. Although you look at that, Black Panther was out, at the beginning of the year, Stephen, last year.
Yeah,
that was even further back again. But I think it was perhaps just unfortunate, Black Klansman.
A Star Is Born, I loved the film, loved the soundtrack as well. I knew it was going to be in amongst a few of the categories anyway. Yeah. I didn't think it was going to be Best Picture, to be honest with you. It's a remake of a remake. Not that that's got anything to do with it, but it was mostly the performance from Lady Gaga and the singing performance from Bradley Cooper that really captured, I think, people's imagination. Yeah.
Have you seen that with the performance, Stephen, in the show? It was very well received.
Yeah, it certainly was,
It was a stunning performance from Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper. But again, you talk about timing, Stephen, of release. A Star Is Born, I think, and I says it prior to the awards, it perhaps peaked a little bit too soon with
By the end of the last year, John, I think we were all tired of that song Shallow. I liked it. I still do like the song, but it's just on the airwaves, it was really just played on the hour every hour.
Yeah.
And as you said, I think it peaked just too early. But nevertheless, still a good film.
Yeah, look, as I said, I'm really pleased that Green Book won, despite the controversy, people comparing it to this generation's Crash, saying that it's kind of a candy-coated take on racism and stuff like that. I didn't think that at all. No. I thought it was a very special film with two really standout performances from Mahershala Ali and Viggo Mortensen, focusing on friendship, breaking down racial divides and barriers.
That was one of the things I liked about it, John. Yeah. It didn't bash you over the head. It was more about the relationship between these two characters more than anything. Everything else was and it was really just the development and the sort of thinking of these two characters, the way they started in the movie and by the end of the movie. I don't really care for all the things that have been said about it. I thought it was a good film. I think we're getting too serious as well with everything that it's released. I think you should just take it on its merit. It was a well-written film, by I can't remember who wrote the film down, but the performances from the two lead actors was fantastic as well. And it was a nice story, you know. It was
Nick Vallelonga, Brian Curry, and Peter Farrelly. Stephen, I've looked down those.
I was going to say Peter Farrelly, but I wasn't sure if it was just him. So, but I thought it was good. A lot of people, I think, when they see Peter Farrelly's name, they're going to think there's going to be a lot of fart jokes in there and stuff like that. But I thought the humour was just right in this movie.
Yeah.
I thought it was a good film. I thought it was a worthy winner.
Yeah, we'll move on, Stephen, to the next topic. I think we're kind of in agreement there. We both enjoy Green Book and we're pleased to see it picking up the win. The next nomination or category is Best Actress.
Mm-hmm.
The winner was Olivia Colman for her performance in The Favourite. And also the runner-up were Glenn Close and The Wife, Yalitza Aparicio. I can't even say the name. And Roma Aparicio, Lady Gaga, and A Star Is Born, and of course Melissa McCarthy and Can You Ever Forgive Me? Now, Stephen, I predicted that I thought Glenn Close would win this one. I actually wanted Melissa McCarthy to win, but I thought the potential dark horse was Olivia Colman, and it proved to be correct. Olivia Colman picked up the win, and I'm glad because it was a very good performance.
Very good speech as well, wasn't it?
Look, I hadn't seen The Wife, but I heard that Glenn Close really did dominate much of the screen time in that film, and she put in a superb performance. So.
Yeah.
I thought it was her year because she's been the most nominated actress never to win an Oscar. So
Never the biggest fan of Lady Gaga, John, but I thought she was worthy of being in, you know, in amongst these other fine actresses. I thought her performance in A Star Is Born, just like I previously said, took us by surprise. How good she was in it.
Yeah.
It was also interesting to see her with not that persona of being Lady Gaga in the movie. I would have liked her to have went one stage further and actually been billed with her real name, you know. Just because it was I think it was quite refreshing for her as well to be able to step out of that bubble, you know, and be able to just be herself, because there was no makeup, there was not the, you know, larger than life hair or anything like that. It was just
and the meat dresses and stuff.
Yeah,
like that.
That's right. They're all meat. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, she said, Stephen, that she was always longing to be an actress. Apparently, she was heavily involved in drama school and stuff like that. That was always her desire, but it never really paid off. Well, now she had her moment in the sun, and now she's picked up an Oscar, obviously for her best song. But we're not getting to that just now. We're talking about best actresses. I did think Olivia Colman did enough to merit the win. It's not surprising to me. It's maybe surprising to American viewers, because usually the Academy don't follow the BAFTAs with their winners, and obviously Olivia Colman won for Best Actress.
Did she win a Golden Globe as well?
I think she did, she won for the Golden Globe,
I've not seen the movie yet, John, so I can't really judge her on that performance, but you know, I'm a big fan of Broadchurch.
Mm-hmm.
Fantastic in that with David Tennant. I've seen her previous work as well, so I don't want to say I was, you know, not too surprised that she won it. Obviously, I was delighted for her, but I was a little bit surprised when you're up against the likes of Glenn Close.
She was Lady Gaga. She says, "Oh wow!" After she won.
She's a worthy winner. I can't wait to see what she does next, to be honest with you.
Yeah, I'll just round up that category by saying everyone apart from Aparicio, I can't say that name, Aparicio.
Aparicio.
Was probably a she was good as well, Steve. She was good, but she was the clear weakest link in that category. But we'll move on to another category where I don't think there was a weakest link, Stephen. Best actor. The winner was Rami Malek for his performance in Bohemian Rhapsody, obviously Freddie Mercury.
Yep.
With Christian Bale in Vice, Bradley Cooper for A Star Is Born, William Dafoe for At Eternity's Gate, and Viggo Mortensen for his performance in Green Book. Now, again, I believe I went for Rami Malek to win. I think Rami Malek to win, and I thought a potential dark horse was Christian Bale. It wouldn't have up to me, Stephen, if I seen Viggo picking up the win, because I thought he was outstanding in Green Book, alongside obviously Mahershala Ali. They two really dominated that. But look, Rami Malek, he was pretty much a stick-on, wasn't he? His portrayal was Freddie Mercury. Such a great performance.
In this case, I would have been surprised if he didn't win it, John, because it was just such a great performance, and it's a very hard thing to do, to step in to someone like Freddie Mercury's shoes.
Yeah.
There's only maybe about, I wouldn't even say a handful, maybe two or three people that could probably pull it off.
Mm-hmm.
His performance, you see those scene-by-scene comparisons, there's quite a lot of them on YouTube, with the real performance and the replicated performance just shows you how much this man has studied Freddie Mercury. He's really invested in the man and the legend. But Christian Bale in Vice as well, you know what you're getting with Christian Bale. Every film he's in, he's much like Daniel Day-Lewis in that sense, where you never get a bad performance.
Yeah,
out
he's
of
always totally dedicated to the
Bradley
cast.
Cooper, again, I was. He didn't act bad in this film. Some of his voice was very hard to pick up, though.
Yeah,
I was more impressed with Bradley Cooper's performing. You know the songs.
Yeah,
I thought his voice was excellent. Willem Dafoe, I can't comment on, John. I've not seen that movie yet either,
but apparently he was outstanding.
Viggo Mortensen, Green Book, I agree with you. I just thought it was absolutely amazing.
Totally unrecognisable.
Yeah, as an American-Italian, Italian-American. Yeah. And I just a great character as well. Such a likeable character, disgusting as well. Never stopped eating. The Kentucky Fried Chicken scenes were some of my favourite stuff.
He's a man of my own heart, Stephen. I love my food as well. I'm not quite as porky looking as Viggo in that film. He's a little bit weighty.
Yeah.
But look, stunning performance from Viggo in that as well. But all in all, I think it's quite harsh on Christian Bale, but that's life. Every year you're going to have a category that's just stacked, and there's going to be another performer that's just done a little bit more and merits it a little bit more. And I think that's the case with Rami Malek. Christian Bale absolutely dominated Vice. If it wasn't for him, the film would have been probably an absolute disaster.
Yeah.
Nowhere near the standard that subsequently was brought up to Bush because of him and Sam Rockwell and obviously Steve Carell. Is that right?
Yeah, Steve Carell,
played Donald Rumsfeld. So those three really propelled that film to a different level. But look, Stephen, we're going to move on to the next category because I haven't got much more to add to that one. And it's Best Supporting Actress. The winner was Regina King for her performance as the mother in If Beale Street Could Talk. And also the losers were Amy Adams for Vice, Marina de Tavira, I can't say these bloody Roma names, I'm not Mexican, for her performance in Roma, Emma Stone in The Favourite, and also Rachel Weisz in The Favourite. Yeah. Now, again, this surprised me. I picked Rachel Weisz for my potential winner. I thought she was probably a stick on, but I was wrong. Regina King won for her performance in Field Street Could Talk. And I'm not surprised because I did watch that film, Stephen, last week, and I was very impressed with the three primary characters in it. Also the young boy, can't remember who played him, his partner who was having his child, and then the mother, his mother-in-law who was played by Regina King. All three of them were very, very good, but I thought it would have been Rachel Weisz's year, but it wasn't to be.
Well, John, I was just going to say that I've not seen If Beale Street Could Talk yet. Amy Adams is a fine actor. She was good in Vice. Was she the weakest link in there? It's a very tough call, but
between
you're
her
right,
and Marina,
I thought perhaps Rachel Weisz as well. But that shows you the caliber of the film, The Favourite. Yeah. When you've got
it was a real trio.
Olivia Colman, winning Best Actress, and then you've got both Emma Stone and Rachel Weisz, up there for Best Supporting Actress, says a lot about the movie. But we'll move on, John, to
Best Supporting Actor. It was Mahershala Ali who rightfully picked up the win for his performance in Green Book. Below that, you've got Adam Driver for Black K Klansman, who was superb as well. Sam Elliott for A Star Is Born. Richard E. Grant in Can You Ever Forgive Me? And Sam Rockwell for Vice. Now, again, that's a stacked category, Stephen.
That's enough,
I have to say. Richard E. Grant was really, really good. And I was hoping, a small part of me was hoping that he would pick it up just because of his almost childlike enthusiasm. Yeah, he's got a childlike enthusiasm for just the whole award season after obviously being nominated. I think it was the first time he was nominated for an Academy Award. But look, I can't argue against Mahershala picking up this one. He's just an incredible actor. And he was probably the standout performer there.
Yeah. I think, Sam Elliott is probably the best actor out of that bunch. But I don't think his role in A Star Is Born was big enough. A couple of memorable scenes, but I just don't think, I know it's a supporting actor, obviously he's not going to be at the forefront, but I just don't think he was in it enough to warrant that nomination.
Certainly not
who am I to argue with that?
Well, you're right, Stephen, he didn't have his chunky roles as Richard E. Grant, Sam Rockwell, or Mahershala Ali, or even Adam Driver, who was really, really good in that film, provided a lot of comedic levity.
But Mahershala Ali, for me, definitely was absolutely the winner in this category. I thought he was outstanding. It was good to see, the black actor being the educated elegant character in the film, mm-hmm. to I was thinking another word there,
Tony
but
Lip.
Tony Lipp's
he's not ignorant, but you know,
not
I mean,
ignorant,
he's
just less educated,
yeah, he's less refined,
and less cultured, and yeah, basically a slob, you know. It was mm-hmm. just refreshing to see that in a movie.
Yeah, but shall move on, Stephen, because we haven't got much more to add to that one. That was a deserving winner. Best director, the winner was Alfonso Cuarón Roma. Below that you have Yorgos Lanthimos for The Favourite, Spike Lee for Black Kay Klansman, Adam McKay for Vice, and Pavlikowski for Cold War. Again, Stephen, I've not got much complaints for this one. I think Alfonso Cuarón, it was a real passion project of his, and he put a whole lot into that film. His heart and soul into that film. He was responsible for the writing, the cinematography, the directing. So it was a real hands-on approach he took, and I think it was a very well-crafted film. And he's thoroughly deserving of his win as best director. Yorgos Lanthimos, very, very good as well for The Favourite. Spike Lee, again, he's just an absolute giant in the cinema business. And it's kind of surprising that that was his first Oscar win last night for a couple of nights back last night. Getting losing the pot here, Stephen.
Yeah.
Nearly a week ago now. But he was deserving of his Oscar win for, I think it was original screenplay for Black Kay Klansman, perhaps, I think it was. But look, Stephen, Adam McKay and Pavel Pavlikowski, I think are really making up the numbers in this category. If there was going to be a winner, it would have been between Lee, Lanthimos and Cuarón, and I think Cuarón just about edged it.
I can't disagree with that, John.
No. So we'll move on on that note. Yes, we'll move on to best original screenplay. The winner was Green Book. This was written, as I did say, by Nick Vallelonga, Brian Curry.
If only I scrolled down earlier, I could have actually got the writer's names.
Yeah, Peter Farrelly, yes. They won, and they rightfully won it for me. I thought it was a beautifully crafted film. It had a lot of touching moments, a lot of comedy in there, and it was just very linear in its direction, Stephen. It was simplistic. It could bring in every single demographic.
I think as well, John,
and film fan.
Just the way it's written as well, it offers the movie a rewatchability as well, just because it's so layered. And that's down to the storytelling as well.
Yeah.
You've got all these little, I wouldn't say subplots, they're just like sort of side issues and stuff like that.
Yeah.
The main focus is obviously on those two men. Mm-hmm. But I thought it was beautifully written. I thought the script as well, some quotable lines in there as well from the screenplay.
Yes.
And just the way the two characters are written, I can see why it won it.
Yeah, Stephen, I don't know what crack I've been taking today, but obviously Black Kay Klansman wasn't the winner of original screenplay.
Best
because
adapted.
I'm reading out. Yeah. Best Adapted, was that the winner of that? Yeah, the next one down. Yeah. I'm reading out Best Original Screenplay, John. Get a grip of yourself here, son. Hey, can you tell I've had about 5 hours sleep, Stephen? I really am in a downward ebb just now. But look, man, out of all of those films, I can't argue with Green Book. I wouldn't have been able to argue if The Favourite picked it up, or indeed Roma or Vice, because they were all very good films. I haven't seen First Reform, so I can't possibly comment on that. But all in all, a lovely winner, again, for me, the Academy of... on a run here, Stephen, for me.
I had the Buster Scruggs there, I was surprised to see in there.
Yeah.
And that's not a slant on the movie, John. I thought Joel Coen and Ethan Coen did a remarkable job on this. I did a review on this, I think, in January.
Mm-hmm.
I loved the movie. This was a Netflix film, wasn't it? I don't know if it was an original.
It was a Netflix original.
Was it? I couldn't remember. I thoroughly enjoyed that movie, but I'm surprised to see it in there amongst the likes of Black Kay Klansman and A Star Is Born.
Mm-hmm.
But I think Black Kay Klansman is the worthy winner in that category.
Yeah, absolutely, Stephen. And it was great to see Spike Lee also picking up an award. He was very excited about it. He was jumping on to Sam Reynolds.
Some character.
Yeah, sadly, later on he kind of went down a rabbit hole. But we're all human.
Yeah.
That's life. Can't argue with any of the nominees being in there, Stephen. I actually thought if Beale Street could talk, we'd nab it. But look, I really enjoyed Black Kay Klansman as well, so I'm glad to see it picked up the win because it was a thoroughly enjoyable film and it deserved some recognition come the big award time. Also, I say big award time because there's a whole host of shows, but the Academy Awards are the real best shows. They're the best ones. But we'll move on that note to the best animated feature, which was won again by Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, the fitting winner. It was a great little category here, Stephen. Incredibles 2 was in there. Isle of Dogs, Ralph Breaks Internet, Mirai, I've not seen Mirai.
I
really enjoyed all of those films. I have seen Out With Mirai, but I just feel like Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse was just on another level.
It's been a strong year for animated films.
It is,
when you look at those those films in that category.
Mm-hmm.
Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, again, I did a review, I think it was on Christmas Day I did this. Just an amazing film visually.
Mm-hmm.
I've never seen an animated film have so much texture in it and style, yep. And different styles, as you recall. All these versions of Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Phil wasn't in there. But just all the different ones, these characters from different styles, all amalgamating into this one storyline, and it worked. That's what I liked about it. I loved the story of Miles Morales as well. I'd only heard about him, I'd never read the comic books. To see him up on the big screen when I went into a cinema, it was great watching it on the big screen as well, John, as you recall. Yeah. Just visually, a stunning film. Mm-hmm. I know there was so many, I think it was about 180, was it? As many as that?
I think it was, yeah. I think you said it was about 182 different people worked on it. And just the dedication they had to the craft, Stephen. They actually created five separate films, which they condensed into one so they could do it in a way where it all weaved in organically and it wasn't too jarring.
Yeah.
But all those various different styles were stunningly put together. They shouldn't have worked, but they really did work, and that was down to the absolute brilliance of the animators. So, thoroughly deserved the win for Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. The next category, though, Stephen, is Best Foreign Language Film. This is going to be a very short conversation indeed, because I've only seen one of these films. It was won by the one that I had seen. That's a tongue twister. It was won by the one that I had seen. Well, and it was Roma.
John, I think when we come down to these categories, when it comes to a bit of a more of a niche,
it's going to be very short.
It's going to be very short and sweet, because we've not seen all these movies. But I think, I can't say it's a worthy winner, but I think it was an impressive piece of filmmaking. I get why it's the best foreign language film this year as well. Mm-hmm. I've not seen the other films, unfortunately. Some of them are hard to come by as well here in Scotland.
Capernaum, I've heard, was pretty decent, Stephen, and Cold War, by all accounts, was a beautifully crafted film as well. But Roma, for me, is the outstanding foreign language film in that category, and it thoroughly deserves to win, so I've got no complaints again. We're going to move on, though, to another topic. Topic, I keep saying that. It's just ingrained into me, Stephen. Another category, which is going to be very short and sweet, because I've not seen any of them. I don't know about you. But the winner was Free Solo. We discussed Free Solo, and this is also for Best Documentary Feature, incidentally. We did discuss that briefly on Box Office Chat, and apparently it was very well rated, received.
That's right,
And it was about a free climber, I believe, climbing the various peaks in the world. So that is supposed to be outstanding. But the other ones in that category were Hale County, I was about to say Country, This Morning, This Evening, Minding the Gap, of Fathers and Sons, and RBG. Now, I don't know anything about any of these films, Steve, because I haven't seen them. But by all accounts, Free Solo isn't being argued by many of the people who have seen them all.
So,
on that note, I'm going to move swiftly on to the very next category, and it's Best Original Song. The winner was, surprise, surprise, Shell, from A Star Is Born, also performed by Lady Gaga.
Damn song again.
Bradley Cooper, and produced by Mark Ronson, Anthony Rosomando, and Andrew Wyatt. So, I think that was a fit winner again, Stephen. There was a couple of ones in there. I liked All the Stars by Black Panther.
I loved that,
But Kendrick Lamar didn't turn up, so he knew he wasn't winning. So he threw a hissy fit and he didn't even turn up. So that's fair enough. I haven't turned up either. Waste my time. Although, if I was getting invited into that Governor's Ball after party, I think I would turn up on my line yet. But look, When a Cowboy Trades His Spurs for Wings, I don't know if you recall that one.
That's fantastic,
Yeah, from the Ballad of Buster Scruggs.
Absolutely amazing,
But I think the deserving winner, Shallow. I think you can
I think so, and I think it's just because it's in... The
charts for so long.
The pop culture. I think Matt Ronson comes across as a very decent guy as well. I saw his very brief speech. It's very hard to get a speech in there when you've got Lady Gaga sharing the stage with you.
But, crying.
I think he was very honoured as well.
Yes.
To receive the award, and I think rightly so as well. I think it's a very good track. The actual, I was going to call it the album, the actual soundtrack was fantastic all throughout the movie as well. It was very consistent throughout as well, but I thought it was a worthy winner. You're right, I think All the Stars as well was a fantastic piece of work. I liked that. The Place Where Lost Things Go and Mary Poppins Returns is one of those songs that maybe in years to come. Maybe in years to come, it'll stick in their heads a little bit more. I've seen Mary Poppins Returns twice now.
Yeah,
it's a song that kind of stands out.
Yeah, it's a definite standout of the film, Stephen. Yeah. I actually forgot all about it.
As I said, I loved When a Cowboy Trades His Spurs for Wings. It was a fantastic. That was right at the very beginning of the film. I don't want to say too much because I know you've not seen the film yet. But that was right at the very start. It was a great little song.
Yes.
Very memorable as well. Great sequence, but I think Shallow is the worthy winner of Best Original Song.
Yes, I concur, Stephen, and we're going to move on to the Best Original Score. score now, which was won by Black Panther. It was performed by the composer Ludwig Göransson. Yeah,
cool guy.
The other people in the, he is indeed a cool guy. The other people within the other composers in this category were obviously Terence Blanchard for Black K Klansman. Very distinct horn heavy kind of a, I want to say horn, but a distinctive score anyway. That was you hear that main theme and you know right away that's Black K Klansman. Nicholas Britell, obviously, if Beale Street could talk, that was the guy who I'd picked. I said he was a stick on to win, and he didn't, which is a shame because it was a beautifully melancholic arranged string, sort of a heavy score. But I digress, I can't argue with Black Panther winning. Eight of Dogs was done by Alexander Desplat,
yep.
Who was an outstanding composer, and I really enjoyed that whistle. Sort of a organic whistle heavy score. Mary Poppins returns in there, obviously Mark Shimon and Scott Whitman. So all in all, it was a very, very good category, Stephen. And although I picked if Beale Street Could Talk's score as my personal favourite, I can't argue with Black Panther. I actually forgot how good that African themed kind of a mix match of African and modern stuff, how good it was.
I think Göransson is the worthy winner here, John. Mm-hmm. I saw his speech as well, as I said. Very cool guy, very humble as well in receiving his award. Mm-hmm. But I can't argue with that, John. I thought Black Panther was a worthy winner of the best original score.
Yes.
We are going to be back after this short message.
If you're liking this video, then why not check out our other content on our channel? Every Tuesday, we break down the top 10 films in the UK on Box Office Chat. Every Wednesday, we discuss the latest entertainment news on Movie Burner News. Every Thursday, we chat about the latest movie reviews from our writing team on the Blog Rundown. And we wrap up the week and get ready for the weekend with the Force Friday show, where we discuss the latest news in the world of Star Wars. If you're liking the content we're putting out, then do subscribe to our channel by hitting that subscribe button and click the bell to receive alerts. And welcome back to our little breakdown of the Oscars, obviously the Academy Awards 2019. Steve, we're going to fire swiftly on to the next category and get right into this. We're getting into the tail end of the categories now, so we'll try and keep it short
some
and succinct.
Some of the more interesting ones.
The more interesting ones, yes. Some would say the more mundane ones. I don't echo those sentiments at all. But the next one is Best Production Design, Stephen. There was another surprise here for me. I say that, but perhaps not. The winner was Black Panther. It was obviously Hannah Beechler and Jay Hart. And the other category, or the other films within that category, were The Favourite by Fiona Crombie and Alice Felton, First Man, Nathan Crawley and Kathy Lucas, Mary Poppins Returns, John Meyer and Gordon Sim, Roma, Eugenio Caballero and Barbara Enriquez. Now, I say a surprise team because I actually had The Favourite picking this one up. I thought that was a stunningly crafted production, but look, I can't argue again with Black Panther. It's obviously a big blockbuster Marvel Cinematic Universe film, and a lot goes into these films. We've seen the likes of Kevin Smith going onto these sets and saying it's almost like a big a country, the size of the scale of the production. So
I can't argue with
the production design.
I think First Man is rightfully in there as well. I think just the sheer look of that film really captured the time of these events. Mary Poppins Returns as well, I think, really captured the feel of the original movie in the sense of your surroundings, costume, etc. I know that's a different category, but just the sheer feel of those two films as well, I think, really captured that. I can see why they're in there. I've not seen The Favourite yet. I've obviously seen trailers, you know, snapshots of
the crafty film.
Yeah, you can see why, you know, it's up there as well. But I totally agree. I think Black Panther is the worthy winner. Yeah,
great seeing another comic book film getting recognition, Stephen, in the biggest stage of them all for award ceremony.
So, that's fantastic,
We shall move on to another category where the Black Panther won again.
Yeah,
it's Best Costume Design, and this is also Ruth E. Carter, who was involved in the Black Panther film. But we've also got The Ballad of Buster Scruggs in there by Mary Soffres, The Favourite, Sandy Powell, Mary Poppins Returns, Sandy Powell again, she's been a busy girl, and Mary, Queen of Scots, Alexandra Byrne. Now, Stephen, I had The Favourite picking this one up again because I thought that 18th century English period piece, just those weird and wondrous sort of outfits they had on, the men are running about with wigs on and the makeup, I thought that would have picked it up just because it was flamboyant in its costume design. But look, again, Black Panther. There's so many very epic costumes going in, are happening in that film, Stephen. Obviously, T'Challa himself and these various people hanging around Wakanda. I don't know their names, so I can't remember them.
No,
so I can't go through, but the likes of obviously Peter Nyong'o.
Such a long time ago we saw the film, John, so it's very hard to
remember.
Who was
the mountain leader, the mountain king? He also had the bones and stuff, and
I know you're talking about, yeah, but I can't.
Very, very cool guy and very cool costume design. So I've got no bones about
the Ballad
Black
of Buster Scruggs as well, John, just for that, that way.
It's
out,
a very strong category.
That white outfit that Tim Blake Nelson wore as well, very iconic from the start, you know.
And very authentic.
Yeah, it certainly was. But I think, I don't think I can disagree with that, John. I think. Some of the costumes that were in Black Panther are so memorable.
Yeah.
The Black Panther costume itself.
Yeah, it is. But also the
gold.
It's
such an iconic. It changed, didn't it?
It did. I'm thinking he had purple or all black. Yeah. And then it changed to gold when he became also the king of Wakanda.
But I think his actual suit as well changed from Civil War. I think that was highlighted in the film,
I think it did.
They said that there's been an upgrade to his suit.
And then also Killmonger as well, Stephen. He had a whole host of interesting stuff going on in that. I don't know if the actual... I don't presume that the ritualistic things he had on his body, that would probably come under makeup and costume. Obviously instead of costume design, but it was a very beautifully crafted, obviously, film in terms of costume design. But the likes of Mary Poppins and Mary Queen of Scots as well, very stunningly put together. So it was a very strong and obviously stacked category. But I've got no qualms about our issues with Black Panther picking up the win for that one, Stephen. But we shall move on because I've not got much more to add, and I don't want to start gibbering away like a incoherent drunk. So I'm going to go on to Best Cinematography, and also the winner is Roma by Alfonso Cuarón again. Again, thoroughly deserved. That was an incredibly short film, just the utilisation of black and white. There was a whole sort of a rainbow of mid shades of grey, black, charcoal, and white, and subtle differentiations in the colour, Stephen. So I can't really argue with that one. And again, I've not seen Cold War, so I can't speak of Lucas Zal's cinematography in that. But the favourite, Robbie Ryan, that was an incredibly short film as well. Some interesting techniques being used where he's kind of sitting the camera down low and doing like wide shots, almost panoramic wide shots of some of the interior scenes, which was quite nifty and quite cool. Never Look Away, I have not seen, but so I can't discuss Caleb Deschanel's or Deschanel's cinematography. But obviously Matthew Lebitike, I can't say that name, Lebitike.
Put me through the ringer tonight.
Put me through the ringer big time, Stephen. For A Star Is Born, that again, it was a stunningly short film. There was a very interesting use of filters and stuff like that in that film, which added so much to it. Its aesthetic appeal to me. But look, Roma is the clear winner for me.
Yeah, it sounds silly saying the colour palette of Roma, but it's a black and white film. But you're right, there's so many shades in there. And
it's not like the old school ones, Steve, the silent movies.
And it's deliberate as well.
Yeah,
so
a lot more going on in
there. I thought there was a lot of thought went into that.
Yeah.
And, you know, Alfonso Cuarón, I think, was a worthy winner of Best Cinematography.
Absolutely, but we shall move on, Stephen, to Best Visual Effects. The winner was First Man. This is a contentious one for me. The winner was First Man. Paul Lambert, Ian Hunter, Tristan Miles and J.D. Schwalm were involved in that. This is going to be a long one going through these different nominees because there's a whole lot of names in there. So I'm just going to shorten it down to the film, Stephen. I'm not going to subject myself to that. Avengers Infinity War, Christopher Robin, Ready Player One and Solo, A Star Wars Story made up the rest of the nominees. Now, I have to tell you, Stephen, I enjoyed First Man. I'm glad to see it get recognition and to some extent because it was a beautifully put-together film.
Not in that category.
But not in that category. Yeah. I liked the visual effects, I have to say. The realism of the moon, the way it was stunning.
Yeah.
The way they utilised some of the test flights and stuff, seeing the parachutes coming down and things like that. It was very, very cool. But I have to say, in a category which involves the likes of Avengers Infinity War, Ready Player One.
Yeah.
And even Solo, A Star Wars Story. We were just discussing Solo, A Star Wars Story on last week's Force Friday show.
Yeah.
The brilliance of the CG and just the effects that were utilising slow motion within the water, taking minuscule little explosions and expanding up to make it look like a thermonuclear explosion.
I think what we're getting to, John, at this stage now in filmmaking is that...
I think it's become desensitised.
You know, that's exactly it, John. It's becoming the norm now that it's underappreciated.
Yeah.
What goes into it. That's why I appreciate these documentaries coming out because it does show you the sort of the attention to detail for some of these effects. But you're right. As much as I loved First Man, and I thought some of the visuals in it were absolutely stunning. When you've got the likes of Avengers and Infinity War in there, which I felt should have won it.
Yeah, but that's just Ready Player One,
I was going to say as well, because that the visuals carried that film because I felt the story was very weak, and I felt the visuals were absolutely outstanding. But you're right, you get the likes of Christopher Robin in there as well. We just take it for granted now for you know actors talking to these
teddy bears,
these teddy bears animated characters now.
Yeah.
It's just part and parcel of where we are in filmmaking. But I can't have too many annoyances with the winner, because I think it should have won something.
Yeah.
It's just in the wrong category.
Yeah.
For me, it should have been Infinity War.
Certainly struck me as them throwing a dog a bone, Stephen, in this instance.
I think so, yeah.
Look, I don't agree. I think Avengers Infinity War already play once you've picked up that one. But look, that's life. They threw it a bone, and I can't really argue with that, as you did say, Stephen. But I'm going to move on that note to best makeup and hair styling. The winner was Vice. Greg Canham, Kate Bisco, and Patricia Dehaney were involved in that one. The other nominees were Border, Goran Lundstrom and Pamela Goldhammer, Mary Queen of Scots, Jenny Shercour, Mark Pilcher and Jessica Brooks. Now again, I can have no real gripes with Vice. Obviously, the way they transformed Sam Rockwell into George W. Bush, Steve Carell into Donald Rumsfeld, Amy Adams into Dick Cheney's wife, and first and foremost, Christian Bale into Dick Cheney, yeah, Stephen. That was incredible. And the transformation, he really did look like him, not just when he was older and a little bit more heavy set, but even in the younger days, it was an incredible piece of work for the makeup and hairstyling.
Like Chevy Chase.
Well, there you go. Yeah, he did a bit. He did a bit now, Chevy Chase.
Yeah,
not back in the 80s.
I
can have no complaints. Perhaps Mary Queen of Scots could have been a dark horse in there, obviously, with the way they transformed Margot Robbie.
Haggard
looking Queen Elizabeth, obviously. Yeah. Strange. But I digress, I'll move on, Stephen. I'm not complaints with that one either. That seems to be a prevailing theme throughout this breakdown. I've not given many complaints, just a couple of niggles in there. That's all personal choice. But look, best sound editing was won by Bohemian Rhapsody. Yeah. It was John Wathurst and Nina Hartstone. And the other nominees were Black Panther, First Man, A Quiet Place, and Roma. Now, I think I picked Bohemian Rhapsody to win best sound editing. I would have been surprised if A Quiet Place won, but I wouldn't have been upset just because of the way they utilised sound and stuff like that.
It's good to see. I know I'm kind of jumping the gun on in our category here, John, but it's good to see that Bohemian Rhapsody did win best sound editing and best film editing, because I think the two of them went like that in this movie.
Yeah.
I felt the editing in this film was fantastic from visuals and sound.
Also the life. And when, stuff.
Yeah, definitely, John. And all those little intercuts as well, when, you know, another One Bites the Dust scene, when that kicked in as
That was cool, wasn't it?
It was just the whole sequence of that, when they went from the sort of...
the bass.
The raw, the bass, and then the drums, and then right into the track.
Yeah.
Just seamless, you know, and I thought it was well done.
Yeah, and that carries into best sound mixing as well, Stephen, where Bohemian Rhapsody also picked up the win. Yeah. Paul Macy, Tim Cavigan, Cavigan and John Casale were the winners for sound mixing, and I can't argue with that either. Black Panther, First Man, Roma and A Star Is Born were the other nominees. I've got no complaints
with
Bohemian Rhapsody winning any of the sound categories, nor indeed film editing, although it won film editing, as you did say, Stephen, John Oatman. I have to say that was a much stronger category, and there could have been an argument for really any of those films win.
Oh, definitely,
First and foremost, Vice, which did pick up the editing award in the BAFTAs. Mm-hmm. Hank Corbin, that was a film which really had to be edited together very well, or it wouldn't have worked at all, because it was a whole mishmash of different eras and perspectives. But look, Bohemian Rhapsody, as you did say, the way they utilised the live scenes and stuff like that, the live performances, and cut it all together,
It was
beautifully put together. So I've no any complaints with that one either, Stephen, and I'm going to move on. Very short and sweet.
I was going to say, the last three categories, John, are going to be very short and sweet.
They are indeed.
Pardon our ignorance.
Yeah, they're all short, Stephen. So nice little pun. Best animated short, the winner was Bale. The other nominees were Animal Behaviour, Late Afternoon, One Small Step and Weekends. Now, I've not seen any of these films.
No.
And I'm going to go right on to the next topic, because I can't add
but
anything.
But well done to Bale.
Well done to Bale, Best Documentary Short, the winner was Period, End of Sentence. Cool title, incidentally. Black Sheep, Endgame, Lifeboat, A Night in the Garden were the other nominees. I've not seen any of them.
No.
I can't say
unfortunately
at all whether it was justified or not. And the final topic in this breakdown of the 2019 Academy Awards, Stephen, is Best Live Action Short, and it is winner, Skin was the winner, I should say. Detainment, Fauvy and Marguerite and Mother were all the other nominees. Was Mother the one with Jennifer Lawrence? I don't think it was. That was from a couple of years ago. I'm talking about my...
You know, the one they're talking about as well.
It had an exclamation mark instead.
Yeah, I think so.
This one doesn't have an exclamation mark. But look, again, I've not seen any of the films, Stephen. Can't possibly discuss their merits or what was perhaps the rightful winner.
No.
Because I haven't seen them.
But listen, John, overall, I think we could only speak for ourselves, but I think it was a very well and worthy Academy Awards, the 91st Academy Awards. I enjoyed the show, enjoyed the speeches as well.
Yeah.
A couple of surprises in there that... maybe peed me off a little. Other ones I was delighted with.
Yeah.
But overall, I thought it was a very successful night. And there was no presenter as well, John. Yeah, there was no leading the show, which yeah. I felt was... I was... Beforehand, I thought it might have been a little bit flat, but I felt everyone that was on stage played their part.
It worked very well, yeah. Stephen. I have to say, it didn't take away from the entertainment value of the show. I watched 2.5 hours of it, 2 hours of it live, and then I had to go to my bed because it was so late, and then yeah. I went back and watched the rest of it the next day. But it was a nice paced show. It was just over 3 hours long. I think that's just perfect. Didn't drag on, and I think that was probably down to the lack of presenter. So, look, I enjoyed the show. I like the spectacle of it all. I like it's the culmination of a year's worth of entertainment. That is definitely the big event. I mean, I love the BAFTAs. I watch that every year. I love the Golden Globes, but this is the big one, Stephen, as I did say earlier. Not in so many words. I kind of butchered it. But I really enjoyed the show, and can't really argue with most of the winners. I enjoyed and agreed with 99.9% of the winners. Just that bloody visual effects or whatever the hell it was that First Man picked up.
Can't win them all, John.
You can't win them all. No, I didn't win anything.
I'd just like to thank you once again for joining us on this very special edition of Movie Burner News, where we have broken down the 91st Academy Awards show. Just like to thank you once again for joining us, and we will be back again tomorrow with the Force Friday show.